Today I'm going to give you a full tour of a beautiful luxury liner in Star Citizen's. The D2E merch store is open. There are t-shirts, sweaters, hoodies, mugs, and tote bags with many cool designs. Head down to the link in the video description and get yourself your merchandise today. Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to Star Citizens with Outworth Astronomy. What we have here in front of us is the Orion 600i, a absolutely beautiful luxury liner. And I'm going to show you everything. We're going to go over the interior, all the different cabins, all the different spaces, and you're going to get the full tour. We're going to start here on the outside and just take in the beautiful look here. There are two basic ways into the ship. There's an elevator right here, and there's a larger elevator over here, but we're going to come back to that in a minute. For now, we are just going to call this elevator here. Like so. And we're going to ask that to send us up to... We're going to start it on the lower decks. As we step out of the elevator, we arrive in this small lobby. The elevator is right here behind us. And I think we're actually going to go ahead and we're going to start by checking out the master cabin, which we have in here. And what a cabin. Have a quick look around. We can see we have a little working area here. Nice, so you can keep track of business or whatever you're doing. I should say that this is a owner's operated ship, meaning there is probably not going to be that much crew on board. It's mostly going to be something the owner will be flying himself. Maybe there's going to be room for having a pilot, but other than that, you're not going to expect to have crew on board that's going to stay for an extended period of time. Continuing here in the master cabin, we have, of course, a bed. And just imagine waking up to this view. Right now we are in quantum drive mode, so this is the fast travel mode, but just imagine waking up to this view every morning. Now, it might seem a little odd that there is no real ensuite here, but it is actually hidden over here in the corner behind this door. If we go ahead and open that up, we can see we come into the first little basically this is a small like combined dressing room slash ensuite. With some cloth hangers over here for your clothes. And if we continue in behind this door here, we find the toilet and a rainfall shower. Very nice. Now, let's head back out here, back into the owner's room. And again, a nice little social area here, which you want to like get a bit away from the rest of the ship. You have your own little private sitting area here where you can relax with a book, as the current owner clearly has. But we're going to head back out here to the lobby, and then we're going to continue straight, and we're going to head in here to this little, it's actually rather big. This is essentially a tender garage. This is intended for you being able to store a vehicle of some sort. So this is most likely where most guests would be arriving. This whole floor panel here, I'm not going to do it now because we are in space, so we're not going to go ahead and open elevators now. But this whole thing, whole center part here of the floor will lower down. You can drive a vehicle up, race it back up into the ship. Alternatively, you could also use it for more sporty equipment if you want to have some toys or something here that you can play around with as an owner. But mainly, this does work as a tender garage for some kind of vehicle to pick up guests or to get yourself on and off the ship. If you don't want to use the other elevator where you, of course, will be walking. Now, this is where we entered. If we're going to head back out here on the opposite side, we're going to come into yet another small lobby area. There's an elevator here that's going to take us up to the upper decks. We're not going to go there now. Instead, we're going to continue down the hallway here, and we're going to check out the guest accommodations, which we find in here. Now, the current layout I find to be a little weird. We can see we have these four single beds in each corner. And they also come with a small sitting area and a small screen, small TV for entertainment. But there's very little privacy in here. And that seemed odd for the type of ship that it is. The only explanation I can come with is that these grooves you can see here on the floor, that there must be some kind of, I don't know, screen or wall that you can take up or down or something like that to kind of give these a more private feel, because as it is right now, this seems like a really, really odd layout. But if you were to be able to put up some screens here or some actual walls to kind of give a little bit more privacy to the guests, I think that would be beneficial. If we continue up the other end of that little area, we comes to, well, there are some storage out here. There are escape pods. This is something you see on many ships, but especially on these luxury liners, it's quite common to see escape pods like this. And if we continue past the escape pods, we get to the shared, well, will also work as the day heads, I guess, but also the shared ensuite from the four guest beds back there. Each of them has their own little, as you can see here, their own little basically hanging locker where they can put, it's not really a locker, there's no door on it, but you can store things like a shoe and a jacket and something. Not something you would use for extended periods of time. And the fact that you are sharing this, I mean, if you want to change your outfit or you want to get some other clothes on, well, you have to share with the other guests. You do have two separate toilets or ensuites here. And again, with the same rainfall shower as we saw in the master cabin. Again, with towels and room for other stuff here. We're going to head back out to this escape pod area and back into the crew accommodations. Going to head straight through the crew accommodations and back out to the elevator. Let's just go ahead and let's call the elevator and let's go and check out the top deck, because this is where the fun really begins. And here we are, coming out of the elevator. We are going to come into this area here in a second. First, I just want to head up here. Behind this door, we have, this is basically suit lockers, space suit lockers, as well as an armory locker. So I guess if you want to go and do some hunting or something, you can have weapons stored in here, as well as various suits and armors can also be stored in this area here. So this is like a gear room where you would also, well, there's plenty of room in here for storing other kinds of smaller toys and stuff like that. You can definitely store in here. But that's the elevator where we come in. If we move in here, we get to the main entertainment area here and the aft end of the ship. First of all, a very, very well catered for bar, as we can see here. Look at that lining there at the top. That looks absolutely amazing. The plate and the way it just continues down into the floor. That looks great. On either side, we have ramps that comes down to lots and lots of seating area. You could really imagine having some really nice parties in this place. And again, the same tabletops are continued down here in this area here, with even more social space here for people. And as we continue down the steps, we get to a small entertainment area with a TV where people can sit back, relax, watch some TV. Moving further back on the ship, we have a pool table. That's quite neat, I think. Nice to see that they put that in there. And if we move further forward, we get to the galley. Again, we have seating space really only for three people here. So you probably are not expected to have huge dinner parties on board. This is more of a party liner where you could hold some pretty neat parties or like cocktail parties or something like that. But you do have the galley here, fridge and freezer with an ice maker, and lots of storage. Really nice. Here on either side, right next to the galley here, if we open up here, we get into the engineering areas. You can see we have all the electronic equipment in here. And heading in through this door, we can see we get access to even more of the electronic equipment that can all be controlled from in here. And it's the same story if we move across this entertainment space. We can see here once again more engineering spaces, and the same in here, pretty much mirrored from the other side. And I think this is really where the ship shows that it is not intended for carrying crew, at least not permanent crew, because if anybody needs to get access to the engineering space, they have to come through the whole guest area here. And similarly, you have the galley here, which is very much integrated in as part of the whole social area. So again, really is a owner-operated ship. And also something I found quite funny is this little roof they made in the floor here, so you can look up and you can see that it continues up, so you can actually look out onto the space, onto the stars from here. But if you move up on top, this has a small, I think, unforeseen downside. And that is here, you can see this is the other side of the window, and it's right where the bartender is going to be standing. So if someone's standing there and you're walking down there, you're going to be looking right up underneath them. Not too pleasant. But again, the view up here is absolutely amazing with full glass roof, so you really get a good look of the night sky. Now we're going to move back out to this little lobby area, and we're going to head back here. That was the elevator where we came up from the lower floor. And we're going to head back here. Now, this room, I believe, is cartographics. So basically like a mapping room. Why they have decided to allocate this much space, or if it has some other use, I'm not really sure about. But it seems to be a awful lot of space that they have decided to allocate for cartographics on something that's essentially a luxury yacht. So this room really puzzled me. As nice as it looks, it does puzzle me a bit. But if we continue through the room, we get here, there's another elevator. That's the other end of the elevator we came up with, where down there was where we exited. But we continued to take it all the way up here to the top floor. And here again, we see three escape pods. So those would probably be accommodating the owner as well as a spouse. And then probably one crew, which would most likely be the pilot or the captain, who is in here. And here we have the bridge. We can see right now we have Don Galora sitting here flying the ship. He has been renting the ship for us today, and is therefore also flying. We're here in New Babbage. Just take a look at that view. That is astonishing. But we can see it does have crew seats up here for three, but again, there are no accommodations for them unless you want to put them down in the guest accommodations, which I guess you could. But I guess we're going to end this little ship tour by taking a view of New Babbage from one of the seats that will allow us to sit in. There we go. And just take a look at that. I really like that they also put these two forward seats here, so even if you have someone on board to actually fly the ship, you can come up here as an owner, have a chat with the pilot, and just really enjoy the view. Thanks a lot for watching, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, remember to give a like, subscribe, and until next time, I'll see you guys in space.